Greetings world. We are anonymous. Turkish Prime Minister Erdogan has shut down Twitter, sparking a general outrage. Prime Minister Erdogan has taken the state repression of Turkey's citizens' freedom of speech to a whole new level. The news started to spread like wildfire. Twitter has been shut down. During a campaign rally for the upcoming municipal elections in the western city of Bursa, Erdogan had declared to a crowd of AKP supporters that he was determined to shut down the social media platform. "We now have a court order. We'll eradicate Twitter. I don't care what the international community says. Everyone will witness the power of the Turkish Republic," he stated in his typical authoritarian fashion. The Prime Minister had already threatened to shut down Facebook and YouTube. These mediums had been used to share and spread the leaked telephone calls between himself and his son Baylor, discussing how to zero out the millions of dollars of stolen cash they had hidden at their homes. But after statements by the country's president, Abdullah Gül, who said that their closure is out of the question, the people took Erdogan's rhetoric for just that, rhetoric. No one expected this blatant closure of one of the country's main communication systems. Twitter is not only used by the opposition, both within and outside of the political arena, but also by the country's leading duo, Gül and Erdogan, who both have over 4 million followers. Despite their strong social media presence, the Prime Minister apparently felt threatened by what he himself termed a robot lobby, which he accused of targeting the government through Twitter messages. With this latest move, Erdogan seems to have finally and definitely lost it. After the funeral of young Berkin Elvan, a 15-year-old boy who died after having spent 9 months in a coma because he was shot in the head with a tear gas canister by the police during the Gezi protests, Erdogan had accused the boy of being a member of a terrorist organization. These hate-inciting and utterly ridiculous remarks were enough reason for the Turkish Doctors Association, the TTB, to release a press statement in which they collectively expressed their concern over the state of Erdogan's mental health. "We are doctors. We know human beings and the status of their minds from the inside and outside. We are concerned with the mental state of Prime Minister Erdogan. We are deeply concerned," the statement read. Ever since millions took to the streets in the context of the Gezi protests last summer, the spirit of dissent has never left the collective's imagination. Tens of thousands of people in Turkey continue to publicly voice their anger with the current government. Large protests have rocked the country, protests against the destruction of the forest at Ankara's ODT campus, against the building of Istanbul's third bridge, against the new internet law, against the country's corrupt ruling elites in memory of young Berkin Elvan, and against the increasingly authoritarian rule of the AKP government in general. The closure of Twitter is only the latest attempt by the AKP to crack down all voices of dissent. In a country which jails more journalists than any other country in the world, the freedom of speech provided by online social media platforms was like taking a breath of fresh air amidst the toxic fumes of the increasingly authoritarian neoliberal and consumerist swamp Turkey has turned into. The closure of Twitter is made possible by a new internet law that places extrajudicial powers with the Communications Technologies Institution, which now has the power to close down websites within a few hours within a court ruling. However, the people of Turkey have proven to be as defiant online as they are on the streets, and the reports of the closing down of Twitter were followed closely by links to VPN services and DNS servers that could be used to circumvent the ban. No one shuts down the internet on our watch. We are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. To Turkish Prime Minister Erdogan, this is just the beginning. Expect us to continue the fight.